Dearest Peggy, the ground departs from beneath my feet, and the nightmare in which I eternally fall becomes reality. It has been 9 months since the madness of General Comstain Dynamics plunged us into the ceaseless disgrace of a war. He says soon, to overhauled loot, to a cosmetic rework, to an endgame, to everything. These lies continue to poison the minds of simple men. I pray history remembers what actually happened. All I wanted was to squeeze them titties. Yours, with love, Poggers, Captain America. Hello, beta testers. I've received hundreds of thank yous from people that I spared from wasting money on this buggy mess of a game, and I'm here to confirm that it's just as buggy and broken as it was at launch 9 months ago. Players falling through the map, enemies falling through the map, that's if the enemies even spawn, bugs that you don't even need luck to replicate because, in most game modes, they're guaranteed. Shout out to the people who wasted their time in Last Avenger Standing just for enemies not to spawn towards the end, no matter how many times they reload. Developer Crystal Dynamics never ceases to amaze by demonstrating how tone-deaf and incapable of catering to fans and players they are. I'm still getting hard crashes in this bitch 9 months out. People are starting to believe that they're deliberately sabotaging their own game, a theory that gets a little less tinfoil every day. Now, if they had something to show for the time that they spent ignoring the community, it'd be one thing. They would probably lead off with that instead of dumping out this buggy content that they clearly intended for the end of the Hawkeye DLC, but had to delay it, just like they promised a patrol mode on the roadmap and had to delay that. So, if they're still delaying things, what guarantees the validity of whatever roadmap they fart out right now? See, unlike sexy ASMR females on Twitch, nobody wants to pay for your farts, Crystal Dynamics. The memes are all true. All of it. If this were on Xbox Game Pass tomorrow, there would be better ways to spend your time than on this mess of a game disgracefully wearing the Marvel coat of paint. When opening a chest in your fucking game is hard, maybe you got a problem. When your game's loot is so stingy that there's not even a chance for the highest level loot to drop anywhere, oh come on boy, you're a looter. Comics, patterns, rewards used to drop, but not anymore, baby. And progression is being slowed down for the confused and overwhelmed defenders. Too stupid to process that their personal experience is not indicative of everyone else's. They're somehow blind to social media, where people are struggling, just trying to figure out why the game can't work, but if they can't at least agree that doxing is bad, then of course they're all beyond reason.
It only impacts a small amount of people, right? You know, streamers, content creators, people who want to broadcast themselves playing the game, right? Even though it's impacting a small portion of your population, the bug that does impact a small amount of players. But the unfortunate thing is that even though it impacts a small amount of players, even though this bug may only affect a small amount of people, if you're not a streamer, if you're not someone who cares about broadcasting your gameplay, does this impact you? No, it really doesn't.
I hate this channel.
No! No!
If you're not a content creator, you're going to look at that and be like, whatever, who cares, right?
This is not okay. This needs to stop now. This is cancer.
In Marvel's Avengers, there is currently no infusion system to bring your gear up to a higher level, so whatever terrible loot people manage to get now will inevitably be invalidated over time, since the devs make it abundantly clear that a level cap is on the horizon. This might not be a big deal in a normal looter, but remember, Marvel's Avengers hasn't added a single new enemy faction in the 9 months since the bitch has come out, and has only managed two villains in that time since, you know, Super Adaptoid is waiting to be a part of the endgame mode that this live service still does not have. You know how Destiny's Vault of Glass raid came out a week after Destiny launched in 2014? Jesus Christ, this game won't have a raid. for a full year after launch, if whatever it gets can even be called a raid. I feel like I should be calling people alpha testers. There's no modding to replace perks on the filthy RNG pieces that don't even have a chance of dropping everywhere. And what's particularly disgusting, Crystal Dynamics, is that you have the data, privately and publicly available, to observe the blatant struggle of tryhards who care enough about good gear to back up their saves and reroll for a good piece hundreds of times, but you're too lazy to factor this in to developing your game. Nobody wanted Mega Hives shortened. The community has made it clear for 9 months they wanted it multiplayer, and otherwise they wanted it fucking removed. But I can fix Mega Hive right now and make it suddenly worth the replay. You want to know how? Make it grant rewards on every completion, guaranteed. Stop this one time a week bullshit. You can put it back to 8. As long as you actually give people the gear, they'll run it. You want to really enhance the quality of life and make people fucking happy? Allow players to select the gear slot that they want rewards in. It's too many motherfucking dice rolls. Is this gonna have good perks? Is this gonna have good stats? Am I gonna get it in the right fucking slot? Jesus Christ. You could easily implement this kind of shit if you were paying attention and if you gave a shit about anything more than your $14 fucking recolors. You flinch quick to shut shit down in the AM on a weekend if your precious skins are on the line, but you ignore fans letting you know that a floating string of text are their fucking IP addresses when you know it. You have to be exposed by journalists and forced to admit your failure, even when it puts people's privacy at risk. In private, you letting people know in your fucking echo chamber, but publicly, you wouldn't want to do it. You can't be accountable unless forced, unless bullied into it, because you know it would sacrifice your precious sales. Your ongoing mismanagement of something that outside of your specific crusty Kamala Khan incarnation has made so many people happy is deplorable, Crystal Dynamics, and it's sad that the most excited that you make people is in waiting to see how you fuck up next. The game's current state is so below rock bottom that any positive changes would be instantly noticeable. You wouldn't have to convince people that you're listening or you're comic book fans. You could effortlessly show them the way that that mobile game seems to be dunking on you right now. But Crystal Dynamics is legitimately trying to convince fans they're totally listening now. Never mind the past 9 months, you know? They didn't have their glasses on, they didn't have their hearing aid in. Man, it's a shame that there's no place that pretty much held on to all of these criticisms and suggestions in that time. I love these comments in my comment section going, "This isn't constructive, bitch." It's time for constructive bullshit 9 months in, when all of that other shit that we suggested still hasn't made it in. They're looking into it. They'd love to do it soon. We can't help but laugh being told your resources are finite when you spend your apparently finite development resources nerfing progression to make your XP boosts more enticing. Now you're wasting time overtuning Omega level threats? The endgame mode that you were meant to crap out soon after launch? Because what, you think they're raids? No matter how obnoxious, obstacle-filled, heroic-draining, and lame you make these encounters, it won't be a challenge for the people who are still actually playing this. Take a look at Godslave's channel and use him as a fucking benchmark. Don't look at your candy-ass weirdos that you've made part of your approved creators. They don't play. They don't know. And they're not intelligent. Here's some wisdom. You should be polishing Wakanda to a mirror finish, making sure multiplayer encounters work flawlessly, figuring out phase in and phase out and join in progress for your fucking patrol mode, and recoloring some human enemies so that they aren't more aim. I genuinely hope that a month and a half is enough time for you to suddenly release your first bit of content that is not burdened and plagued by bugs. As usual, Crystal Dynamics, good luck. Beta testers, thank you for listening to this point. Like the video for me and let me know what you'd like to see me play in the future. Until then, join me for the upcoming Marvel Future Evolution stream, where we finally see what the hell they have to say. about the future of this title. Later.